Sarasota, Florida. Sarasota is a city in Sarasota County on the southwestern coast of the U.S. state of Florida. The area is renowned for its cultural and environmental amenities, beaches, resorts, and the Sarasota School of Architecture. The city is at the southern end of the Tampa Bay area, north of Fort Myers and Punta Gorda. Its official limits include Sarasota Bay and several barrier islands between the bay and the Gulf of Mexico. According to the U.S. Census Bureau, in 2013 Sarasota had a population of 53,326. In 1986 it became designated as a certified local government. Sarasota is the principal city of the Sarasota metropolitan area, and is the seat of Sarasota County. The islands separating Sarasota Bay from the Gulf near the city, known as Keys, include Lido Key and Siesta Key, which are famous worldwide for the quality of their sandy beaches. The keys that are included in the boundary of Sarasota are Lido Key, St. Armand's Key, Otter Key, Casey Key, Coon Key, Bird Key, and portions of Siesta Key. Previously, Siesta Key was named Sarasota Key. At one time, it and all of Longboat Key were considered part of Sarasota, and confusing contemporaneous references may be found discussing them. Longboat Key is the largest key separating the bay from the Gulf, but it was evenly divided by the new county line of 1921. The portion of the key that parallels the Sarasota city boundary that extends to that new county line along the bayfront of the mainland was removed from the city boundaries at the request of John Ringling in the mid-1920s, who sought to avoid city taxation of his planned developments at the southern tip of the key. Although they never were completed in the quickly faltering economy, those development concessions granted by the city never were reversed, and the county has retained regulation of those lands. The city limits had expanded significantly with the real estate rush of the early 20th century, reaching almost 70 square miles. The wild speculation boom began to crash in 1926, and following that, the city limits began to contract, shrinking to less than a quarter of that area. According to the United States Census Bureau, the city has a total area of 25.9 square miles, of which 14.9 square miles is land and 11.0 square miles is water. Sarasota has a humid subtropical climate closely bordering a tropical savanna climate, with hot, humid summers, and warm, dry winters. There are distinct rainy and dry seasons, with the rainy season lasting from June to September, and the dry season from October to May. The most recent officially recorded freezes in Sarasota took place on January 18, 2018, when the temperature dropped to 30 degrees Fahrenheit at the Sarasota Bradenton International Airport. However, Sarasota averages less than one frost annually. As of the 2010 U.S. Census, there were 51,917 people residing in the city. The population density was 3,541.4 inhabitants per square mile. There were 29,151 housing units at an average density of 1,988.5 per square mile. The racial makeup of the city was 7,1,754,100,000,000, spate, 75.41% white, 7,1,151,100,000,000, spate, 15.11% African American, 6,999,430,000,000,000, spate, 0.43% Native American, 7,133,000,000,000, spate, 1.33% Asian, 6,998,400,000,000,000, spate, 0.04% Pacific Islander, 7,522,000,000,000, spate, 5.22% from other races, and 7,234,000,000,000, spade, 2.34% from two or more races. Hispanic or Latino of any race were 7,001,166,300,000,000,000, spade, 16.63% of the population. There were 23,427 households, out of which 19.7% had children under the age of 18 living with them. 35.3% were married couples living together, 12.3% had a female head of household with no husband present, and 48.5% were non-families. 38.3% of all households were made up of individuals, and 16.3% had someone living alone who was 65 years of age or older. The average household size was 2.12 and the average family size was 2.81. In the city, 18.4% of the population was under the age of 18, 9.2% ranged from 18 to 24, 27.9% from 25 to 44, 22.5% from 45 to 64, and 22.0% were 65 years of age or older. The median age was 41 years. For every 100 females, there were 94.6 males. For every 100 females age 18 and over, there were 92.8 males. The per capita income for residents of the city was $23,197. Females had a median income of $23,510 versus $26,604 for males. The median income for a household in the city was $34,077 and the median income for a family was $40,398. About 12.4% of families and 16.7% of the population were below the poverty line, including 28.5% of those under age 18 and 7.7% of those age 65 or over. Tourism contributes significantly to the economy of Sarasota. Companies based in Sarasota include the Boar's Head Provision Company. Major employers include Sarasota Memorial Hospital, Doctors Hospital of Sarasota, APAC Customer Services, L3 Aviation Recorders, The Zenith, and Capgemini. Sarasota Municipal Government was last incorporated in 1913, changing from a town type to adopting the city type of local government found in the United States, and the title of its government changed to City of Sarasota. Sarasota later was designated as the county seat when Sarasota County was carved out of Manatee County in 1921 during the creation of several new counties. In 1945, the commission manager government form was adopted for the city, and it is governed by a 5-person commission elected by popular vote, 2 members of which serve in the ceremonial positions of mayor and vice mayor, as chosen by the commission every April. 2 at-large commissioners are elected by all voters, and the city is divided into 3 districts for which the residents of each elect 1 district representative to the 5-member commission. Many aspects of the city are overseen by the county government, ranging from the schools, the libraries, the bay, major waterways, county-designated roads, the airport, fire departments, property and ad valorem taxes, voting, the health department, extension services, stormwater control, mosquito control, the courts, and the jail. Therefore, the election of county commissioners is important to city voters. In January 2006, the city of Sarasota made national news when the National Coalition for the Homeless and the National Law Center on Homelessness and Poverty ranked it number 1 on the group's list of 20 meanest cities in America in their published report A Dream Denied: The Criminalization of Homelessness in U.S. Cities. The city's adoption of its No Lodging Out of Doors Ordinance on August 15, 2005, Ordinance No. 05-4640, made it illegal to sleep outside on public property without permission, as was already the case with private property. Sarasota is among the communities included in a 2-county federally mandated metropolitan planning organization that includes all of Sarasota and Manatee counties, and the chairs of the 3 elements of that organization belong to the 8-county regional planning organization for Western Central Florida. Sarasota has been a consistent cultural mecca for nearly a century. In 1925, A.B. Edwards built a theater that could be adapted for either vaudeville performances or movie screenings. Renowned stripper Sally Rand did her bubble bath and fan dance here. Tommy Dorsey, Will Rogers and Elvis Presley each performed at the Edward Theater. It remains at the intersection of Pineapple Avenue and 2nd Street, having been restored and used for performances by the Sarasota Opera and others. It is listed on the National Register of Historic Places. In the early 1950s, the John and Mabel Ringling Museum of Art purchased a historic Italian theater, the Ozzolo. This theater was originally built for Queen Caterina of Cyprus Palace in Ozzolo, Italy in 1798, but was dismantled in 1931. A. Everett Chick Austin, the museum's first director, arranged the purchase and reassembly of the theater for performances of plays and opera. In the 1960s, the Van Wezels enabled the city to build a performing arts hall on the bayfront. The auditorium, the Van Wezel Performing Arts Hall, was designed by Frank Lloyd Wright's successor firm, Taliesin Associated Architects team, under the direction of William Wesley Peters. Wright's widow, Olga Vanna Lloyd Wright, who participated in the project, selected its purple color. In 1989, Stuart Barger, a local architect, designed and oversaw the construction of another Ozzolo Theater, housed in the Florida State University Center for the Performing Arts. It is a multi-theater complex, located farther east on the John and Mabel Ringling Museum of Art property, being placed between Bayshore Road and Tamiami Trail, and facing south toward Ringling Plaza. It was built around a Rococo, historic Scottish theatre previously called the Dunfermline Opera House, which had been shipped to Florida. The new complex also provides venues and facilities for students of Florida State University's MFA acting program, the FSU/Ozzolo Conservatory for Actor Training. This was the administrative home of the Sarasota French Film Festival for several years. Other Sarasota cultural attractions include, and many other musical, dance, artistic, and theatrical venues. Florida Studio Theater has been operating in downtown Sarasota since 1973. FST is a not-for-profit theater that produces contemporary plays, musicals, and musical reviews. Currently, FST has four operational theaters: the Keating Main Stage, the Gompertz Main Stage, the Goldstein Cabaret, and the John C. Court Cabaret. Florida Studio Theater also has three in-house restaurants, and is slated to open a new experimental space, the Bone Lab, in early 2014. FST has the third highest subscription base of all TCG Laureate regional theaters in the country. Sarasota has many musical, dance, theater, circus and other performing arts venues, including the Sarasota Ballet, Sarasota Opera, Ozzolo Repertory Theater, Florida Studio Theater, the Sarasota Players, the Banyan Theater Company, the West Coast Black Theater, the Urbanite Theater, Sarasota Contemporary Dance, Sarasota Orchestra Louisiana Musica, Jazz Club of Sarasota, Sarasota Youth Opera, Circus Arts Conservatory and many others. Sarasota boasts a selection of theatrical venues that have diverse offerings, from Broadway and off-Broadway to classic plays to contemporary and new plays. Performances can be found at the Florida Studio Theater, Ozzolo Repertory Theater, Van Wezel Performing Arts Hall, the Players Theater, Urbanite Theater and the West Coast Black Theater Troupe. The West Coast Black Theater Troupe of Florida was founded in December 1999 by local actor, singer, director, and playwright Nate Jacobs. It is the only professional black theater company on Florida's West Coast and one of two in the state. Through the years, WBTT has produced many productions locally, throughout Florida, nationally, and as far away as Switzerland and Germany. Sarasota is the home of the Sarasota Orchestra, which was founded by Ruth Cotton Butler in 1949 and known for years as the Florida West Coast Symphony. It holds a three-week Sarasota Music Festival that is recognized internationally and boasts it attracts renowned teachers and the finest students of chamber music. Sarasota also boasts a symphonic chorus, key chorale, and professional vocal ensemble, Choral Artists of Sarasota. The Jazz Club of Sarasota is one of the largest and most active jazz clubs in the United States and has promoted jazz events in Sarasota for 39 years. Elvis Presley, Tommy Dorsey and Greg Allman each played concerts in Sarasota. Joe Perry, of Aerosmith, Brian Johnson, of AC/DC, Dickie Betts, of the Allman Brothers Band, Donald Dunn, of the Blues Brothers and Graham Edge, of the Moody Blues have all settled in Sarasota. Sarasota and the Cultural Coast are home to fine art, filmmaking and decorative arts. Fine art galleries, artist collectives, filmmaking and many decorative arts are practiced in Sarasota and Cultural Coast. See films, documentaries, television and other media from the Cultural Coast for a complete listing. In 1952, Cecil B. DeMille filmed and premiered The Greatest Show on Earth in Sarasota. In 1998, two studio films were filmed in Sarasota, Alfonso Cuarón's Great Expectations, with Ethan Hawke, Gwyneth Paltrow, Hank Azaria, and Bancroft and Robert De Niro, and Volker Schlöndorff's Palmetto, starring Woody Harrelson, Elizabeth Shue, and Gina Gershon. Out of Time, a crime drama starring Denzel Washington and Eva Mendes, used the Casey Key Swing Bridge, Boca Grande, and Cortez. In 2013, Taylor Hackford's action movie Parker, with Jason Statham, Jennifer Lopez, Nick Nolte had scenes filmed at CHZN in Sarasota. Sarasota is home to Moat Marine Laboratory, a marine rescue, research facility, and aquarium, the Marie Selby Botanical Gardens, the Sarasota Jungle Gardens and the Big Cat Habitat and Gulf Coast Sanctuary. Since 1998, the city has hosted the Sarasota Film Festival annually. The festival attracts independent films from around the world. It claims to be one of Florida's largest film festivals. In 2009, the annual Ringling International Arts Festival held its premiere and held its closing event in the historic Ozzolo Theater, which had been moved and rebuilt again. The historic Venetian Theater now is housed in the reception building for the museum, where it is used for special events as well as performances, informative purposes, and another seasonal film series hosted by the museum. In 2010, the Sarasota Chalk Festival that is held yearly in the historic area of Burns Square became the first international street painting festival in the United States of America. Celebrating the 16th century performance art of Italian street painting, the festival hosted Maestro Madonnaro Edgar Müller from Germany, who created the first street painting that changed images from day to night. The festival has a different theme each year and has introduced new techniques in street art. Other applications of street art such as murals and salligraph graffiti have become companion events also produced by Avenida de Colores Incorporated. The murals are part of the Going Vertical project, and although it sometimes coincides with the Chalk Festival, it is distinct from it and often continues throughout the year. Except for a few commissioned on public property in the Palm Avenue parking garage, the murals are on private property and they are in many sections of Sarasota and in Manatee County as well. As of 2014, the Sarasota Chalk Festival has relocated to Venice, Florida, a small town just south of Sarasota. The name Sarasota Chalk Festival remains the same. It is also home to the Harvey Milk Festival, an independent music festival in support of civil rights, focusing on the LGBTQ community. It has been celebrated in May annually since 2010 on the weekend closest to Harvey Milk's birthday, and is currently the largest independent music festival in Sarasota, with thousands of attendees throughout the free, public, multi-day event, that also includes gallery showings, film, and other live performances. Italian architecture and culture are quite strong in the area because of the Ringling Museum. An unusually large number of homes and buildings are designed in the Italian style, especially Venetian, as influenced by Ringling's Cozzan. Italian-inspired statues are also common, and Michelangelo's David is used as the symbol of Sarasota. The Sarasota School of Architecture developed as a variant of mid-century modernist architecture. It incorporates elements of both the Bauhaus and Frank Lloyd Wright's organic architecture. The style developed as an adaptation to the area's subtropical climate and used newly emerging materials manufactured or implemented following World War II. Philip Hiss was the driving force of this movement. Fellow architects creating new adaptive designs were Paul Rudolph and Ralph Twitchell. The second generation of the school includes Jean Leedy, Jack West, Victor Lundy, Mark Hampton, William Rupp, James Holliday, Ralph Zimmerman, as well as several who still practice in the community: William Zimmerman, Carl Abbott, Edward J. Tim Siebert, and Frank Folsom Smith. Rudolph's Florida houses attracted attention in the architectural community around the world. He started receiving commissions for larger works, such as the Jewett Art Center at Wellesley College. In 1958, Rudolph was selected as director of the School of Architecture at Yale, shortly after designing the school's building. He led the school for 6 years before returning to private practice. Recently, a bank building designed and built by Jack West was renovated and reopened as the headquarters of Gateway Bank on Tamiami Trail at the intersection with Bahia Vista. This followed a preliminary proposal to demolish the building that met with a rapid objection from a leader of historic preservation in the community, Coffee Benz, before the new project could gain approval within the city planning department. The building is graced by a sculpture by Jack Cartledge that was installed when the building was built. By the end of the 20th century, many of Sarasota's more modest historical structures were demolished. Recently, two historic buildings, the Crocker Church and the Bidwell Woodhouse, first restored by Veronica Morgan and members of the Sarasota Alliance for Historic Preservation that she founded, became city property. These structures were relocated to this park, despite protests from residents who objected to the loss of park area. In the late 1970s, Sarasota County purchased the Terrace Hotel that was built by Charles Ringling and renovated it for use as a county government office building. The adjacent courthouse that he donated to the new county in 1921 has been listed on the National Register of Historic Places. The courthouse complex was designed by Dwight James Baum. In the next decade, the landmark hotel built by Owen Burns, the El Vernona, which had been turned into apartments, became endangered. By then it was called the John Ringling Towers and was purchased by a phosphate miner, Gardiner, who wanted to turn it into his corporate headquarters. All of the tenants were turned out and plans were made for the restoration of the building. The city commissioners supported the plan initially, but lobbying to undermine the project began and one of the commissioners changed her vote. The project was denied at the final hearing. The enraged miner abandoned the city and subsequent owners, seeking to demolish it, made garish changes to the building to make it unappealing before finally leaving it open for vagrants to invade and pilfer. Remarkable preservation success occurred during the 1990s when the Community Exhibition Hall, the Municipal Auditorium, designed by Thomas Reed Martin and Clarence A. Martin, was listed on the National Register of Historic Places and meticulously restored to its Depression Recovery Era, 1937 WPA Community Project, completion status and its architectural glory, both inside and out. The city boasts that 100,000 people use it every year and it is a boon to the community for recreation, lawn sports, as well as being heavily attended for auctions, concerts, conventions, flea markets, galas, graduations, lectures, orchid and flower shows, and a full range of trade shows of interest to the community. Later the federal building, designed by George Albee Freeman and Louis A. Simon, which initially had served as the post office was restored as well. Most of the luxurious historic residences from the 1920s boom period along the northern shore of Sarasota Bay also have survived. This string of homes, built on large parcels of elevated land along the widest point of the bay, is anchored by the John and Mabel Ringling Museum of Art at its center. Among them is Cod San, the home of Mabel and John Ringling, which was restored recently. Many significant structures from the comparatively recent Sarasota School of Architecture period of the mid-20th century, however, have not survived. Since they do not qualify under the age criteria set for historic preservation nominations, their historical aspect often escapes public recognition. Others frequently are threatened by demolition plans for new development without consideration of their cultural and historical importance to the community instead of motivating the implementation of plans to retain the buildings and integrate them into new plans. In 2006, the Sarasota County School Board slated one of Paul Rudolph's largest Sarasota projects, Riverview High School, for demolition. The board arrived at the decision despite protests by many members of the community, including architects, historic preservationists, and urban planners. Others supported the demolition as they believed the structure is no longer functional. The issue was divisive. The World Monuments Fund included the school on its 2008 watch list of 100 most endangered sites in the category Main Street Modern. Following a March 2007 charrette led by the National Trust for Historic Preservation, a proposal was advanced to renovate and preserve Rudolph's buildings. The school board decided to allow a year to consider implementation of the innovative plan proposed to preserve the buildings, that would include building a parking garage with playing fields above it rather than demolishing the structures. In early June 2008, the school board voted in a 3-2 decision to allow the demolition. School board members Shirley Brown, Caroline Zucker and Frank Kovach voted against preserving the historic high school. This decision was that school would be demolished and that a parking lot would replace it. 1 year later, in June 2009, Riverview High School was demolished. Several movies have been shot using Sarasota locations. One focusing on the Going Vertical program of street art that is held by the Sarasota Chalk Festival premiered internationally when muralist MTO released his documentary film, FL, Unpremeditated Movie, about some of his work in Sarasota. It is only one of many international films produced about the festival and its artists. Breaking Amish, Brave New World is a television series set in Sarasota in the neighborhood of Pinecraft. It is a spin-off of Breaking Amish. The show Cougar Town on TBS takes place in Sarasota, but is filmed in California. Public education is provided and managed by the Sarasota County Public Schools School District. Elementary schools in Sarasota include the following. Middle schools include Booker Middle, Brookside Middle, Laurel Nokomis, McIntosh Middle, and Sarasota Middle. High schools include Booker High, Riverview High, Sarasota High, Suncoast Polytechnical High School, Sarasota Military Academy, and Oak Park School. Sarasota was also home to the Flint School, a type of boating school. Sarasota is home to the New College of Florida, a public liberal arts college. Additional colleges in Sarasota include Kaiser University of Sarasota, FSU/Ozzolo Conservatory for Actor Training, Ringling College of Art and Design, a School of Visual Arts and Design, and satellite campuses of Eckerd College, based in St. Petersburg, Florida, and Florida State University College of Medicine, based in Tallahassee, Florida. Other colleges in the city include East-West College of Natural Medicine, an accredited college of acupuncture and Chinese medicine. Nearby educational institutions with regional draw include State College of Florida, Manatee Sarasota, and a commuter branch at the University of South Florida, with the main campus located in Tampa. Sarasota is part of the Nielsen-designated Tampa-St. Petersburg-Sarasota television market. The local television stations are ABC affiliate WWSB and the SNN, Suncoast News Network, a continuous local cable news operation run by Comcast, Frontier FiOS and the Sarasota Herald Tribune. WWSB is the only network station with studios in Sarasota. Other network and public television programming serving the community is offered by Fort Myers and Tampa television stations. Comcast provides cable television service. DirecTV and Dish Network direct broadcast satellite television including Tampa Bay Area local and national channels to Sarasota residents. Arbitron has identified the Sarasota-Bradenton radio market as the 73rd largest market in the country, and the 6th largest in the state of Florida. There are 8 radio stations in the city: WSMR, WSLRLP, WKZM, WSRZ, WLSS, WSRQ, WTNY, WTZB and WSDB. WHPT and RUB are licensed to Sarasota and have broadcasting facilities in the Sarasota, Bradenton area, but have studios in the Tampa Bay area and are focused on that region. The community also is served by most radio stations from the Tampa Bay radio market, as well as some stations from the nearby Fort Myers radio market. The Sarasota Herald Tribune is the daily newspaper published in the city. SRQ Daily is published electronically on a daily basis and the Sarasota Observer has changed from a weekly to a daily. A weekly newspaper includes the electronic This Week in Sarasota, TWIS. From neighboring Manatee County, the Bradenton Herald also is distributed daily in the area and the Bradenton Times is an electronic weekly newspaper that covers Sarasota topics as well. Founded in 1957, Scene Magazine is the longest-running community lifestyle magazine. In 1937, the Municipal Auditorium Recreation Club was built with funds provided by the Works Progress Administration, the municipal government, and local residents and business owners. It became a center for sports, entertainment, and recreation. The sports activities have ranged from badminton, basketball, boating, lawn bowling, and shuffleboard, to tennis. The auditorium hosts clubs for cards, dancing, games, gardening, and numerous hobbies, as well as having become the community meeting place for commercial and educational shows and the venue for local schools and charities to hold events and dances. Tourists are attracted to exhibitions provided by local businesses as well as vendors from national circuits. This building was listed in the National Register of Historic Places because of its architecture and for providing the enormous range of community activities that are scheduled at it every week. Sarasota also is home to Ed Smith Stadium, where the Baltimore Orioles currently have spring training. The Orioles also have minor league facilities at Twin Lakes Park. The agreement with the Orioles also places a Cal Ripken Youth Baseball Academy in Sarasota. Previously, Ed Smith Stadium was the spring training home of the Cincinnati Reds and the minor league Sarasota Reds. The warm climate helped the Sarasota area become a popular golf destination. John Hamilton Gillespie was an early pioneer of the game in Sarasota. The Sara Bay course in the Whitfield area was designed by golf architect Donald Ross. Bobby Jones was associated with the community course in Sarasota. Many courses dot the area, including the one originally laid out for the Hotel John Ringling planned on the southern tip of Longboat Key. Sport fishing attracted enthusiasts to Sarasota and the area because of the amazing bounty of the bay. Tarpon was the biggest draw, but gigantic gar as well as many other species abounded to attract people such as Owen Burns and Powell Crosley. The first settled permanently and became one of the most important developers of Sarasota and the second, who more typically, built a winter retreat here and participated in the sport via the clubs, organizations, and tournaments focused on fishing. The Sarasota Marathon started in 2005. In 2010, declining sponsorship and marathon registration led organizers to change the event to a half marathon. The race begins and ends near the John and Mabel Ringling Museum. Sarasota is home to two swim teams. The most well-known, the Sarasota Sharks, have been around for many years and have won numerous national championships. The newer team, the Sarasota Tsunami, was founded by the former Sharks head coach. The teams maintain a rivalry. The Sarasota Sailing Squadron is a highly active facility that has hosted many nationally renowned regattas for both dinghies and larger vessels. In 2013, Sarasota became the home of the Sarasota Thunder, which was to play in the Ultimate Indoor Football League, but the team folded. In 2014, Sarasota hosted the Modern Pentathlon World Cup Final. Bendersen Park in Sarasota was the venue for the World Rowing Championships in 2017, held on September 23 to October 1, 2017. Sarasota is home of the Whiskey Obsession Festival, the largest whiskey festival in Florida. Established in 2013, the festival features several hundred whiskeys from around the world. Dozens of professional brand ambassadors and distillers participate in the festival by participating in a panel discussion, leading classes and tastings. The major airport in the area is Sarasota-Bradenton International Airport, which is shared by Sarasota and Manatee counties. It has since being opened in 1941 the area's major airport. Before this, Lowe's Field functioned as the main airport for the Sarasota area from 1929 to 1941. Five airlines offer service out of the airport to locations primarily in the United States and Canada. The airport serves more than 1,300,000 passengers per year. The airport holds full port of entry status, providing U.S. customs inspections for international travelers. St. Petersburg-Clearwater International Airport and Tampa International Airport are located about an hour north from Sarasota, and Southwest Florida International Airport in Fort Myers an hour and 45 minutes south of Sarasota. All three offer a wider range of national and international flights. Sarasota County Area Transit has a bus service called SCET, which offers service throughout the county and also offers limited connections with Manatee County Area Transit. Sarasota County has joined the Tampa Bay Area Regional Transportation Authority to plan and build future transportation infrastructure, including light rail, commuter rail, and longer-range bus service. A key issue is providing Sarasota with access to the Florida high-speed rail. The Seaboard Coastline ran intercity train service to the city until 1971. There is no Amtrak train which stops in Sarasota, but Amtrak provides through bus service at Sarasota Station, in front of the downtown Hollywood 20 Cinema Complex, to the nearest Amtrak terminal in Tampa. A freight-only rail line operated by Seminole Gulf Railway does serve industries in Sarasota. As a city located on the Gulf of Mexico, water transportation is a key consideration. The Intracoastal Waterway is a 3,000-mile waterway providing water access to and from the Atlantic coast for tugs, barges, and leisure boats. Port Manatee and the Port of Tampa both provide nearby deep water ports. Port Manatee provides cargo service primarily, while the Port of Tampa is more diverse. Port Manatee formerly even had a cruise line, Regal Cruise Line, that operated out of and from 1993 to 2003 until it was seized by U.S. Marshals on April 18, 2003 for not being maintained. The waterway enters Sarasota Bay, which provides access to downtown Sarasota at the city pier. Because of its location on the Gulf of Mexico and its proximity to several other large metropolitan areas, road transportation is critical to the Sarasota area. The major roads in the area include: following the introduction of the work of Michael Walwork to the city by a member of the Sarasota-Bradenton Metropolitan Planning Organization's Citizens Advisory Committee, Sarasota has adopted the use of modern roundabouts for intersections in several locations in the city. The municipal government intends to construct a series of modern roundabouts along Tamiami Trail that will become a national example of the success of the innovation. After building one at the intersection of Main Street, Pineapple Avenue, and Central Avenue, a series has been constructed nearby along Charles Ringling Boulevard at the entrance to the historic Burn Square area. The City Commission has chosen to designate the following cities as sister cities, which are cooperative agreements between communities in geographically and politically distinct areas with the stated contemporary objective of promoting cultural and commercial ties. Objective of promoting cultural and commercial ties.